Eucalyptus from Australia. Frangipani flower from Tahiti. Green lemon from Mexico. Cedarwood from the US. Tungabin from Brazil. And of course, some other flowers and fruit. And we will now go back to France for visiting Grasse, the city where Fragonard was founded. And in fact, Grasse is the world capital of perfume since the 19th century. It has a long tradition of perfume making, and you can find so many perfumery houses in Grasse. Mm-hmm. You can also visit our factory there if you want to discover the production process. And there are five local flowers of the city. We have jasmine, orange blossom, mimosa, mayrose, and violet. And we use a lot of them in our perfume. Now we will discover the extraction technique. However, not all flowers can be extracted. There are some flowers, even though they smell good, the essential oil will not smell like anything at all. So in case you need to use this flower to make a perfume, you need to create synthetic acids. We call those flowers as mute flower, so flower that cannot be extracted. The example of mute flower, for example, here we have Lily of the Valley. Lily of the Valley, peony, for example, lila. They are mute flowers, so in case you want to use this flower in your perfume and you need to create synthetic essence, you will use Headspace to capture all the perfume molecule, and the machine can analyze the composition of the molecule. That way you can create a synthetic essence that smells exactly like the natural one. The same technique often we also use for fruits. Fruits have taste but no any smell, so for fruits we also use synthetic essences, and for some other ingredient like caramel, for example, and marshmallow. But for the other flowers, no, I invite you to our... So the first step, of course, we need to collect the flower first before we can extract it. Until the day, actually, we still pick the flowers manually by hand because they are fragile. You cannot use machine, otherwise you will cut the petals. Except for lavender, you can use machine. Now that we have enough flowers to make the essence, we will use different technique of extraction according to the fragility of each flower. For example, jasmine, mayrose, they are fragile flower. You cannot use distillation because the heat will change the smell of this flower. So I will show you the first method, the technique that was invented in the 18th century, and it was specifically used for treating fragile flower. Here we have all blocage for fragile flower, like jasmine, for example. So we will put the flowers on top of a thin layer of animal fat, for example, the fat of nuts. Every day you have to replace the flowers, because after one day, the fat will absorb the fragrance of the flower. We will do it every day until 1 month, so we can obtain a complete saturation of this fat with the fragrance of the flower. We will then mix it with alcohol. We distill it in order to create absolute pomade, the essence that we use in perfume. However, since the beginning of 19th century, we don't use this technique anymore because it took so long. We needed 1 month. Also, it was quite costly, because in order to create 1 liter of jasmine essence, do you know how many kilograms of jasmine that we need? Can you guess? Random guess.
A lot.
A lot? You need 1 ton of jasmine, 1,000 kilograms of flour, only for creating 1 liter of essence. That's the reason it was too labor intensive. We completely abandoned this. So what do we use today for treating fragile flour? I'm sorry. Now we will see the video of extraction by volatile salts.
Come facevamo una volta, vedi? Uguale.
So we will put all the flowers inside of this container. We call it extractor. You still need 1 ton to create 1 liter, but this will be way more efficient. Wash this flower with a chemical liquid. We call it Xan, this derivative of petrol. So the liquid is really volatile. It evaporates easily in a room temperature. So you don't need to use any heat at all in this process. And it takes only 5 hours, way faster than eau flotage.
Must be a good smell in the factory.
Yes. Quite strong though, but yeah. Then after 5 hours, you will see that the flowers, they lose their color and the fragrance. some sort of homemade. This is basically vegetal wax, because when you touch a petal of rose, for example, you will detect your wax. This is what we will collect in the end. We call it la concrete. We mix it with alcohol in order to create absurd, the essence that we can use in perfume. And apart from this technique, we still have distillation for treating the other flowers. What is interesting, for example, different species of rose will require different extraction technique. For example, for May rose from Grasse, it's Rigel rose, you have to use this one. But for rose from Damas, you can use distillation. So here we have the display of distillation over there. We have the element of distillation. I think you are quite familiar with it. We put the flowers and rose in the first container. We let it soil. The steam will pass raw material, capturing all the perfume molecule. And then it will go to the second part with cold water. So the steam will get condensed from the condensation. You can obtain essential oil for perfume and distilled water for cosmetic. So that we have our essences, we will go to the third step. Over here. The mixing part. And maceration. So in this process, we will be able to mix many different essences and alcohol in order to make a perfume. And then we have to leave it macerated around 3 weeks, and by the end of 3 weeks, you can get the perfume. However, you are also able to create eau de parfum, eau de toilette, and cologne. Do you know what is the difference between parfum, eau de parfum, eau de toilette, and cologne? Not just the price, of course, but there is something else. It's the concentration, the ratio of acids and alcohol. So perfume has the highest concentration. At least it has 25% of essence, the rest is alcohol. Eau de parfum, if it's written EAU de parfum, it has only 15% of essence. Eau de toilette has 10%. Eau de cologne only has 5, maximum 7%. However, the intensity of the smell is just the same. Just because it is perfume, it doesn't mean perfume smells stronger than the other. But perfume can last longer because it has less alcohol. So perfume can last a few hours on our skin. But eau de toilette usually only 30 minutes or an hour maximum. However, we don't know exactly how long a perfume can last on our skin. Everyone has different skin type and acidity, different pH. So maybe some people it lasts longer, or some people it doesn't last long at all. And often, the acidity of your skin can also affect the smell of your perfume. So sometimes the smell can also change. So it's better to spray a bit on your clothes and on your clothes. There is no acidity. And we'll move to the last part of the production, which is the bottling process for the packaging. So Fragonard produces parfum, eau de parfum, and eau de toilette. We don't have cologne. And we have two different types of bottle. For perfume, because perfume is concentrated, you don't need to spray a lot. You spray twice or three times, and it can last long. Like for example, for the whole day. Which means you have to keep your perfume longer. That's why Fragonard use aluminum bottle for perfume. We call it Estaño. We started to use this in the Second World War, when there was scarcity of glass. In fact, it's better for perfume because inside of this bottle, you can keep your perfume up to 8 years without changing the smell. Because the bottle protects your perfume from its three main enemies. Do you know what are the main enemies of perfume? Heat, exactly. Light. And humidity. So light includes like artificial light, sunlight, heat, and humidity. As you can see, the bottle is not transparent, we protect it from light. It has special protection inside that protect your perfume from heat, and if you close it correctly, of course, from humidity. But you will still find in our store glass bottle that we use only for eau de parfum and eau de toilette. Because they are less concentrated, you will need to spray a lot so you can finish it faster than perfume, only in 6 months or 1 year. So glass bottle is fine. Even for those, it's better to use before 2 years. After 2 years, the smell will change a bit, the color will change because you expose it to light, heat, especially if you put it in your bathroom, to humidity. And I have another question, for example, when you buy a perfume, do you know how many percent you pay for the marketing in the price of perfume?
60.
60?
60.
60. See? Quite optimistic, at least up to 80% usually. It includes distribution when you have to export the perfume, import the perfume, even when you sell it in the same country, but when you need to pay intermediary like Sephora, of course you have to pay distribution costs. For advertisement, mostly, if you have to hire celebrities, and in Paris, you find it literally everywhere, on bus stop, train station, every corner of the country, of the city, even for inventing the bottle as well, because often you need to collaborate with an artist to design the bottle. That is the reason why it is really hard to find pure perfume. It's easier to find eau de toilette or eau de parfum. because the 20% itself is not cheap. 1 liter of jasmine essence can cost you 25,000 euro because we need like 1 ton of jasmine. But the most expensive flower in perfumery world is iris, but we use the root because basically you can extract the flowers, the leaves, or the roots. For iris, we use the root, we call it oris. It is really expensive because it takes 6 years before we can extract it. 3 years to grow the root, that is long enough, and 3 years to wait until the root is completely dry. 1 kilogram of iris root, not even the essence, can cost you 75,000 euro. If you have some iris at home, you know what you can do with it. Not of, you know, like, drug dealer, you can just like, cultivating some iris. It's more common to collect some iris.
Oh,
okay. And some mute flower, because you cannot extract it, so fruit mute flower is always a matter.
Mm-hmm.
Quite disappointing, right? Next is natural. Alright, so the expert of perfume, we call them le nez, or the nose. They are the one who create perfume. Not all perfumer can be the nose. Only the successful perfumer who create successful perfume, we can call them le nez. And there are 3 perfumery schools in France, 1 in Paris, 1 in Grasse, and 1 in Versailles. Usually, by the end of the training, each perfumer can remember up to 1,000 different smells. We are also able to do that. We only need to train our nose. For example, we associate the smell of vanilla to our sisters. So every time you smell something like your sister, there is vanilla in it. That's one of the ways to remember the smell. Also, if you go to the laboratory, you will find this instrument. We call it the organ, just like the musical instrument. And here we have the notes. So we call each essence as notes. Perfume is like art in the end. Perfumer will create a symphony of many different notes, like in music. There is no limitation how many notes that you can use in perfume. You can use 20 notes, 200 different notes as you want, but you only need to understand the theory behind the mixing of those notes. Each perfume has an olfactory pyramid, which is basically the structure of your perfume. It consists of 3 different layers of notes. We have top notes, middle notes, and base notes. That explains why the smell of your perfume changes in a few hours. Because each note has different intensity of the smell, and it has different volatility. Top notes are notes that are fresh, that are alive, but they are really volatile, so they evaporate easily. Firstly, this is the first impression of your perfume. If you spray a perfume, firstly you will smell this first. We have citric notes, for example, lemon, orange, bergamot. We also have aromatic notes, for example, lavender. After a few minutes, you will notice the smell of your perfume will change, because after they disappear, you will start to smell middle notes. This is the personality of your perfume, the dominant part that will last longer in a few hours. We have some flowers, of course, flowers, fruits, spices, like for example, cinnamon, cardamom, they are here in the middle. After a few hours, now you will smell base note. The function of base note is to bind the other notes in the pyramid. We have sweet note, for example, caramel. We have woody notes, like cedarwood, sandalwood. We also have oriental notes, for example, animal notes, and some exotic, you know, like notes, like wood, for example, or vanilla as well. And this pyramid exists in all kinds of fragrance, even in eau de toilette or eau de parfum. It's never just like jasmine or like rose. It's always a mix of many different ingredients. However, usually for eau de cologne, it only has top notes. That's the reason why eau de cologne is really fresh. And it doesn't last long, not only because it has more alcohol than the essence. It only uses this kind of, you know, like volatility. So it can evaporate easily. Feel free to take some picture if you want. And we will now move to the second part of the tour, which is the user of perfume. So we will start with the history of perfume in the antiquity period. The first civilization that used perfume was the Egyptian. However, initially, they didn't use it for themselves, they used it for religious purpose.